No, no, no.
Oh, yeah!
It's that time of year again! Kool-Aid Man, you ready for Christmas?
Oh, yeah!
Yeah! All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. It's everything on my list, baby. Hey! All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. It's everything on my list, baby.
Oh boy, it's that time of year, you know, Christmas. I know not everyone celebrates Christmas, but this is still an interesting topic. So anyway, you know Santa, right? Well, kids write letters to him about what they want for Christmas right about now. Like, you know, PS5s, wrestling figures, Kit Kats, scratch-offs, all that good stuff. So what happens to those letters? Do parents take them away and write back themselves? Does the post office just throw them away? Or does Santa actually write back? Because, you know, Santa's real. Well, for me, I never got anything back. Seriously, I wrote him so many times, but never got anything back. I don't even know why I kept trying, other than my parents forcing me to do it. Like, why the heck you gotta know, man? Like, this is between me and Santa, dude. Well, in all seriousness, the USPS does have an actual thing for this called Operation Santa. Beginning in 1912, Postmaster General Frank Hitchcock authorized local postmasters to allow postal employees and citizens to respond to the letters, a program that eventually became known as Operation Santa. This information comes directly from the USPS website, and you can be one of the people who actually pretend to be Santa and send a letter and gift to a hopeful kid. That's right, all you need to do is go to the Operation Santa website and adopt the letter. Then you follow the simple directions, most importantly the address that you have to send it back to. Also, you gotta make sure you buy them a gift. Get them something that is easy enough to send back to them or something that they ask for. Then, there you go. You just made a little kid's holiday and gave them a memory they will never forget.
Christmas is right around the corner, and if you're anything like me, getting gifts is kind of a pain in the butt. Typically, I opt out of getting my brother a gift because, I mean, he gets to look at this beautiful face every day, which is really a gift in itself. But that leaves me with my mom and my dad. My mom is pretty easy because you can kind of just write a handmade card out of construction paper and she'll accept it every year and it works. But dads, they're the tricky ones. What do you get them? Tools? Fishing gear? They want cold hard cash? Who knows? But luckily for you, I'm here to help. Here's a list of what I believe are the top things to get your dad this year for Christmas. A good pair of headphones is essential for dads. Don't forget that they were young just like us too. They listen to music just as much as we do. How else do you expect them to jam out to Tom Petty while he's mowing the lawn? Number one dad hats are really the epitome of Christmas gifts for your dad. They're perfect. I got one for my dad last year and he loved it. Trust me, it'll work, guaranteed. It really shows how much you care about them because you don't think they're number two or they're not number three, they're number one. And you need to remind him of that. Summer will be here before you know it. And dads need updates to their outfits too. Just because they say they're okay with wearing the same clothes for the past 20 years doesn't mean they really are. Get them something new and exciting and attractive. They're called dad bods for a reason. This gift goes hand in hand with the last one. If you get him a crop top, you gotta get him a belly button piercing. I mean, really, it's one without the other. It's nothing. And every single dad, trust me, every dad, that means yours, wants a belly button piercing. It's true. They're just too afraid to ask. So, give them the support they need this Christmas. Just imagine your dad walking around with a cute, dangly butterfly belly button piercing. canes are a great gift. They might not need it now, but they will soon. It's a great reminder that time is passing at an uncontrollable rate, and they are way past their prime and their youth, and that soon, one day, they're going to be in nursing homes and not going to be able to go to the bathroom by themselves. Tools. Every dad needs tools. If everyone follows my list, then one day, we can have a bunch of 80-year-old men walking around with AirPods, crop tops, canes, and belly button piercings. Isn't that a dream? And if you want to see it happen, you better buy your dad these gifts this Christmas.
Hey, remember the PS5? Well, too bad, we're not talking about that today. Today we're talking about the other one, Microsoft's new console, the thing I'm still not sure isn't a mini fridge, the Xbox Series X. First off, what is that name? I know the Xbox One wasn't exactly a home run, but I don't think longer was the way to go. At least this time they didn't just throw in another random number that made less sense than the last one. The name still feels like a 5-year-old whose friend found a cool stick, so they picked up the first stick they could find and called it the Stick Series X, and that their stick is now the best. The Xbox and the PlayStation have had somewhat of a rivalry since the early 2000s, with the 360 becoming the clear winner over the PS3 for that generation. This caused a divide among console gaming fans and led to the console war of 2013. After winning with the 360, the Xbox did not see the PlayStation coming back with a vengeance, which they did. PS4 was the winner of the console war and everyone was all geared up for another one. But things have changed. Over the last 7 years, console gamers have put aside their petty differences in part due to crossplay, which has been implemented in a lot of popular games and allows people to play together no matter what console they're on. There's that, and also the fact that PC gaming has taken over, causing consoles to become pitiful by comparison. If you bought an Xbox One and don't want to change what your controller is like, don't worry, the Series X has the exact same controller, besides some minor differences. One thing that might give Xbox a leg up on PlayStation this time around would be their purchase of titles such as Doom, Fallout, and Skyrim. Having these properties under their belt could give them what they need to compete with PlayStation's exclusives. The consoles have only been out for a month, and we're a long way from knowing who will come out on top of this generation. As a PlayStation man myself, I have some very biased opinions on the matter, as you may or may not be able to tell. But fortunately for you have this thing called your own opinion, which will help you decide which one you want to get if you're getting either of them at all. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go never say the letter X ever again.
The NFL playoff race is heating up. With 3 weeks left in the season, teams are fighting for their chance to make the postseason. Both of the NFL teams in our area, the Baltimore Ravens and Washington football team, are in a good position to make the playoffs. The Ravens will likely make one of the 3 wild card spots in the AFC, while the football team will likely win their division, which gives them an automatic playoff berth. Both teams have had turbulent paths to get to where they are right now. To start the season, the football team had really low expectations. They were expected to be bad this season, and through their first 9 games of the season, that was true. They were 2-7 and at the bottom of their division. From that point on, however, they came surging back and have won 4 straight games, now sitting at 6-7 and at the top of the NFC East. A large part of that is due to the stellar play of their defense. The top contributors there are star rookie defensive end Chase Young, defensive end Montez Sweat, and cornerback Kendall Fuller. Together, they have created a well-rounded defense, one that is one of the best units in the NFL. On offense, quarterback Alex Smith, running back Antonio Gibson, and wide receiver Terry McLaurin have led the way. The star of that group is Smith, who has made an improbable comeback after suffering a brutal leg injury 2 years ago. The injury nearly killed him, and he was certainly not expected to play football again. He, however, has defied the odds to make a comeback story for the ages. And even more impressive, he's playing very well and has helped lead the Washington football team to their current 4-game win streak. Washington is a good football team, and if all goes according to plan, they will be playing in the postseason. Coming off an NFL best 14 wins in 2019, the Ravens had high expectations in 2020, but have underperformed a bit, currently sitting at 8-5. Nonetheless, they are still in position to make the playoffs in a very competitive AFC. If they win their last 3 games, they are as good as in, and lucky for them, the rest of their schedule is easy. They play the 2-11 Jaguars, the 5-8 Giants, and the 2-10-1 Bengals. They will need either the Browns, Colts, or Dolphins to lose at least 1 game, and that is very likely to happen. Like last season, the Ravens' rushing offense has been a major reason why they are good. Quarterback Lamar Jackson, running back Gus Edwards, and running back J.K. Dobbins have led the way there. Mark Andrews, their starting tight end, has also continued to be Lamar Jackson's most reliable target. On defense for the Ravens, defensive lineman Derek Wolfe, defensive tackle Brandon Williams, defensive end Calais Campbell, cornerback Marlon Humphrey, and cornerback Marcus Peters have been major contributors. Humphrey and Peters have yet again been one of the NFL's best cornerback duos, while Wolfe, Campbell, and Williams have been one of the best starting defensive lines in the NFL. The Ravens are poised to make the playoffs for the third straight season. The previous two times, they have not been able to come away with a win. Perhaps for them, the third time may be the charm.
Patuxent High School Athletics started a kickball event 10 years ago to raise money for Patuxent families in need over the holiday. This year's event was run by the Calvert Tide Baseball Organization and the Riptide Field Hockey Club, and in total raised over $1,000 in gift cards. During the tournament this year, the Blue Crabs and Snowballers dominated during the seeding portion of this year's tournament. Santa Squad went 1-1 in pool play, the Gangsta Rappers and the Jingle Ballers both went 0-2, and then played each other first round of playoffs, resulting in a dub by the Gangsta Rappers. They then went on to play Santa Squad and secured the dub as well. The Blue Crabs then faced off in the semifinal in a heated game with some iffy officiating, but ultimately resulted in a win for the Snowballers. The Snowballers faced off in the Christmas Kickball Championship. After an early start from the Gangsta Rappers, the Snowballers couldn't hang on, resulting in a championship dub for the Gangsta Rappers. Patuxent staff and student raised well over enough money to help our fellow students in need while also having a great time. A great event for an even greater cause. We take care of our own here at Patuxent. Happy holidays.
Hello, PHS. It's your friendly neighborhood Sabian, and I'm here to teach you about a day in the life of me. First things first, I wake up. After staring into the abyss for about 10 minutes, I admire my P&P. After that, it's shower time.
Dark empty. I may go wrong, don't tell me. Big bullet holes, don't tell me.
Now that I'm all fresh, it's time to get to school.
What do you mean I failed again?
I've exhausted the last of my energy. It's time to eat. I normally DoorDash tropical smoothie cup.
Capacity of coverage to reach more people and places.
After I've eaten the first meal of the day, it's time to get a sick pump to get these gains up. Since my gym and my video game system is so close, I can't help but to play a little video game.
Bro, can I spawn, please?
Now, for my favorite part of the day. I normally sit in my room and stare at the ceiling and think about all the mistakes I've made over this past 17 years. Or what we like to call, bedtime.
Where are you?
What?
Christmas trees, decorate the house with lights at night, snow's on the ground, snow white so bright, in the fireplace is the Yule log, beneath the mistletoe as we drink eggnog, the